last 4 days when I was outside the hall, I saw all the old thought patterns and cognitions had no power over me. And automatically that Shivoham or that intelligence inside was guiding. And my family members are so surprised how
when,
we could.
When you do something as my responsibility, I am there inside you. Yes, you can.
Actually, for those of you who don't know, we had one of the participants from India. She was an elderly lady, and one day she had stomach pain. So we had to take her to a nearby hospital, and Dr. Shanti actually took her to the hospital. And there they did some tests, and then they said that we don't have the full latest technologies to do a full diagnosis. So she has to be taken either to Thailand, Bangkok, or back to India. And that time her situation was not stable enough for her to be taken all the way back to India. So we decided that we will take her to Bangkok, and she was actually taken in a chartered flight from Siem Reap to Bangkok. And I was personally interacting with Dr. Shanti at that time. See, she is here as a participant like any of us. Never for even for a second I saw a hesitation from her side saying, oh, I'm missing the program, because all of us want to be, you know, want more and more to be with Swamiji, to do the processes, especially the way Shivoham is going now. I personally was so shocked to see that there was not even like a 1 second of hesitation from her side to attend to the participant, to the devotee. And she herself volunteered saying, I will take her to Bangkok, be with her, do whatever assistance that is required to make it happen. And she missed 4 days of the Shivoham process. She was not there. The Sri Yantra that time, she was not there.
No, she has not missed.
Yes, she has not missed, but she was not attending the program. And she went with the participant to Bangkok. She was there, took care of her. She recuperated to an extent that she could travel, and then she flew back to Chennai, and then
she was doing what Shiva will do. Whatever you guys do is only imitating Shiva. She did what Shiva will do.
And then she came back yesterday.
Actually, the participant that she became, that elderly lady, she became stable, and she was sent to India by a flight, and there she has reached the family. I also assured them that
Swamiji, what was really shocking for me, Swamiji, is even when I was talking to her and she was in Thailand, normally we have that curiosity over what's going on in the class, what Swamiji is doing now. Not even to that extent. She was completely there, 100% Swamiji.
Actually, it was 100% Swamiji's grace. In fact, both of us felt Swamiji's presence so strongly. Neither I had that thought nor the participant. In fact, she was telling me incidences related to Swamiji's childhood days, school days.
Actually, no, she is the lady for whom I went to dream and told the people to give money.
She was also telling stories of Sri Ramakrishna, and never we felt we are away from the hall, Swamiji. Thank you so much.
And when she came back, so she was actually asking where she should be sitting. And the morning that she came, Ma Premaatma just left that morning. So her spot was right here. So she got not only here, and Swamiji blessed her saying, whatever the 4 days process happened, I am doing that. I have already done the process for you. So he blessed her. And
when somebody takes up a responsibility for a life, as I said, we are all planning to do what Shiva will do. She has done what Shiva will do. I can say these 4 days, she lived Shivoham. There is a beautiful story. Ramdas is one of the great saints, lived in the banks of Ganga. So he had a Ramayana book which he will recite every day. People will come and listen to him. One day a beggar came to him and said that, please give me something, I have not eaten for 1 week. Ramdas was moved by that and he gave that book and said, go to the market and tell this is Ramdas' book, because he was well known in that area. People will buy it for money. With that, eat. He gave it away. And that beggar goes away. In few minutes, Rama appears and says, what is this? You kept that book is God for you and so many years you worship. Then he said, oh Rama, I gave away your word to keep up your word. No more questions?
Swamiji,
behind you. Side.
Behind.
Go ahead.
Swamiji, after all these process, the idea that to fulfill our desires, we have to depend on others. Like we need permission from others to attend any program or especially the spiritual program, Swamiji.
You don't need to.
Swamiji.
You don't need to.
I don't know.
Who said you have to be depending on other persons? I know whom you are telling. The other person, your husband.
Yes. It's not the question of money also, but they don't understand why you should attend program after program. And he says
because
every...
Because he never attended, so you don't know.
He said every December comes, she's nagging, she's torturing me. So now that...
Then you should tell, come on, only December I nag you. Whole year you are free.
For Kailash Swamiji, I
These
need
These are all simple things, it'll all... Now your husband will get used to it and he will not bother, don't worry. It's a big problem.
Yes,
it may
Swamiji.
Be a problem for your husband, not for you. I know it. Yes. Leave it.
Swamiji, seeking your blessings for Kailash. Swamiji.
Tata astu. That's what I know. Already you would have started talking to him. You started talking to him, not yet.
So. They said, don't talk. In Bali, I was talking to them every now and then. Said, this time you don't talk to us. You just better get out. You live peacefully. Let us also. We also live. 21 days, don't talk to us, they said. So I also.
And he knows. If he talks in between, he will have the plan for next program. And moreover, from the program, you will speak in a very high, powerful space. He will not be able to say no. And he knows that. So don't worry.
So this time I didn't talk. First 10 days I didn't talk. Then they themselves sent mail to Sweda. You tell your mother to speak. Tell my mother to speak. Then okay. Only I spoke.
You spoke. You told about Kailash?
No.
Okay.
Not today.
Tatas.
Thank you so much.
What all is people's problems, you see?
Swamiji here. Do you remember in 2012, you had mentioned that 2012, December 2012, will be equal to 108?
Yes.
108 inner awakenings?
Anything you do is equivalent to 1008 inner awakening, I tell you. Now this IE, I can say it is equivalent to 2000. Because, see, we get into the concept of IA, never do it. When I say it is 2000, you come down to doing it, so it becomes 2000. 2000 times thinking about IA and thinking, wow, it is equivalent to 2000, yeah, let me do it.
But we will still have to come for refueling every December, I think.
No, I have not called you for refueling. if you have lived that, that you can live that. But this, you have come to enjoy, not for refueling.
Reason being is, I'd like you to bless me for the next 2000. We are all one by one seeking blessings for the next 20.
That is, come for enjoyment, not for refueling.
But we need that booster dose.
There is no such thing as you need that. There are so many IA participants who have not come here, but they are living enlightenment. They are living the truths. No. See, I am not saying. See, Jnanatma is asking, if it is not useful, why will they come? I am not talking from that angle. What she is talking is that, do we need to come for refueling? You can come not for refueling, just for entertainment, rejoicing.
So, can I ask you for blessings way ahead of time?
Tatast.
Because then I have a whole year to get my resources together.
Tatast. Time, money, everything, you will get it together. Tatast.
Swamiji, can I ask if using silk is considered animal cruelty because of the way they obtain the silk?
The silk which comes by killing the worms should not be used. I already said in India there are brands like a Mysore silk and all should not be used. It comes by killing the worms. And the Kanchipuram silk can be used, which comes by just metal. It is not killing worms. In Kanchipuram also, there is a variety with the killing worms. That should not be used. But the mainstream Kanchipuram silk saris are metal sari. Silk and copper and gold is used. That can be used. And Arani silk saris are okay. Kashi silk saris are okay, because Kashi, no worms. It is completely metal zari. That umbrella you are seeing is Kashi zari. It's complete handmade. The cloth and the thread, everything is handmade. The Mahadeva's umbrella. Rasivaram silk also no worms, ma?
No
worms. Rasivaram silk is a vegetarian silk. And Ammapetai silk is a vegetarian silk. You guys can see the zari work. It's complete handwork. No one knows how much it takes. That is why you guys are not clapping and appreciating. No. You don't need to clap now after I tell you. Only I know how much it takes. It takes around at least 60 working days of a person, this umbrella embroidery. It's complete metal work. Even if you wash, it won't go. Metal work, at least 60 working days it takes of a person. This is the best zari work I've ever seen in India. And the second is Gorakhpur zari. That's also vegetarian zari. These are all vegetarian zaris. Mysore silk is completely worms. That's a non-vegetarian zari.
Swamiji, behind you, Swamiji.
Go ahead.
Swamiji, that actually the cloth is only made of silkworm, no, Swamiji. Zari is a metal, but the cloth...
No. Even the cloth is metal added cotton.
Kanchipuram.
See, in Kanchipuram silk, there is a variety where they use the silkworm from Mysore, where the cloth is the warm silk and the border is the metal. But the mainstream Kanjivaram sarees, which is mainly available with the title Kanjivaram sarees, those are made by the Shaiva weavers, vegetarian weavers. You see, that is why it is called Shaiva Sengundar. Mm. The weavers are called Shaiva Sengundar. Mm. They don't use worms. They use the cotton coated with the metallic shining. The metal powder is used to coat the cotton, made it shining. Mm? Then they use the metal zari. The kaiyil neyiraangala ma. All that will always be vegetarian.
Okay, okay.
அது வந்து பாவு போடுறதுன்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. அந்த நூலை தொங்க விட்டு தே வில் புட் த ரைஸ் அண்ட் ரைஸ் பாயில்டு வாட்டர் இன் தட் தே வில் புட் தட் மெட்டாலிக் த ஜிங்க் சல்ஃபேட் அண்ட் ஆல் தட் ஸோ இட் வில் வென் தே போர் தட் த கிளாத் த த்ரெட் வில் கெட் இன் டு த மெட்டல் ஷைனிங்.
தேங்க்யூ ஸோ மச்
சுவாமிஜி.
எஸ்
how do they get the pearls for the necklaces without killing the clam?
Oh, pearls are cruel, so it should not be used. No pearls. Pearls. Artificial pearls, okay, no problem. That is plastic. No problem.
Swamiji, back side.
Which side?
Back side. Here.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Thank you, Swamiji, for the experience which I have got, and it's much light come to me, and then I feel so much Satchit Ananda. Thank you so much.
Tathastu. Blessings. This time, engineers is the most fortunate batch. I'm taking all the sessions, and they get to ask me directly, Swamiji. And I have to take a separate session for the science of this one mudra.